Well, first of all, President Santos, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Now that the vote results came in, the dynamic has changed a lot. How does the no result complicate the future
negotiations? Same day that the plebiscite was held and the results were offered, I saw a country, at least the people who voted, which were not a big percentage, unfortunately, divided in half, 50-50. And I went out and recognized the result, which is what any president and any citizen should do. And immediately I said, I am the president of the people who voted yes and the people who voted no. So I think this is an opportunity that the results gave us. If the yes vote would have won for a small margin, the country would be more polarized than it is today. So I'm taking advantage of the results and trying to unite the country. And we've been in a national dialogue around a cause that everybody wants, because every Colombian wants peace.
What are the risks of giving either too much credence or too little credence to the most vocal no campaigners?
No, I think if there's goodwill and you have a clear objective, and I have a clear objective, which is get a new agreement and implement it as soon as possible, because that's what I'm hearing all around. You see the people going to the streets, the young people going for the first time to the streets. This has not been present in Colombia for many, many years. People are excited about implementing a new peace agreement. And this is what we're going to do.
One of the most kind of contested areas of the peace agreement has been the special jurisdiction for peace, the agreement on justice. What is the main disagreement?
If you don't recognize that there is an armed conflict, and this is a sort of a fundamental position, then you cannot apply transitional justice, therefore you cannot have peace. So the people who are claiming that there has never been an armed conflict in Colombia or a war in Colombia, when you have more than 8 million victims, well, they're a bit off from the reality. But the real consequence of this is that peace would never be possible, because without transitional justice, there cannot be peace.
The FARC have always said throughout negotiations, there is no way they are going to serve jail time. What is going to happen to that discussion?
We are trying to satisfy as many people from the no sector as possible. Many of the no sector do not insist of a jail, like with the pajamas and the cells like in the regular jail, but they accept alternative sanctions, restorative sanctions, reparative sanctions. It's a new way of applying justice in transitional justice. This is the essence of transitional justice, that you don't have to go to a jail, but you can serve the sanction in an alternative way.
Will the government present an accord that it has managed to renegotiate with the FARC and in consideration of other proposals, or will it seek the approval, in a sense, of the no campaign? How will you manage when you come across an impasse?
In any negotiation, you to try to find a complete consensus, it's almost impossible. Probably some people will not agree. This is normal. But what I can guarantee you is that today we have expanded very much the radius of support for the peace agreement and for a quick solution.
How are you going to determine if a new accord satisfies the people who voted no, or satisfies their concerns.
The legitimacy of the peace process itself is being increased by all this process of hearing everybody. And when we have a new agreement, we will have 80% of the Congress voting for a new agreement, and all the people in the streets claiming and demanding this new agreement. People in Colombia want peace. People in Colombia are fed up with war. They don't want to go back to war.
What do you think is the biggest threat or challenge right now that you face in getting a new accord?
I would say time, because to administer a ceasefire, the one that we have right now, for a long, long time is very difficult. We need to have a new agreement very soon in order to avoid the risks of people getting out, the base of the FARC going to other regions and simply abandoning their organization, and we have to act quickly because of that. Of course, for me, the results of the plebiscite were shocking. I really was not prepared for that, but I immediately said, no, let's convert this into something better. And I shared that with the people who were around me. I said, no, don't get, they were very sad. People were crying. I said, no, let's turn this around. And when I realized that turning it around, I went to the public, I went on national television, I said, I accept immediately the results, but I ask both the yes and no people to unite, because all of you want peace. I've heard you for many months, many years, and people reacted positively. This was something that turned 180 degrees my mood.